welcome students to learn it. This video is for CBSE students of class 12th biology stream. Chapter number is 1 and chapter name is reproduction in organisms. Before beginning the chapter, we should discuss why is reproduction important. What are the bases that all the living organisms reproduce continuously? This topic is directly connected to a term called as lifespan. Now, you will be thinking how reproduction is connected to lifespan. Each living organism has a birth and will have a death in a certain amount of time. For example, when we compare some of the organisms like mayfly has a lifespan of only 1 day. Butterfly has a lifespan of 1 to 2 weeks. Dog 10 to 13 years. Cow 20 to 25. Man 100 years. Parrot 140 years. Banyan trees 200 to 250 years. And the list goes on. Now, when we move from mayfly to banyan tree, the size and complications alignment of the body also increases. So, shorter the lifespan will make them to reproduce constantly, again and again, so that their race can survive. Irrespective of long or short lifespan of an organism, death is a certain phenomenon. That is, no individual is mortal, except amoeba, which is single-celled. Now, let me define lifespan for you. It is the period from birth to natural death of an organism, which is called lifespan. Now, as we have discussed in detail about why is reproduction essential, now let us move to the topic one, which is reproduction. Now, the definition of reproduction is, it is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young ones or offspring similar to itself. Now, what are the functions why reproduction has been going on in organisms are, it maintains life on earth, it helps in enabling continuity of the species generation after generation, it also creates genetic variations among individuals or populations, maintaining population of young, adult and aged person. Various factors affect the reproduction rate, and on the basis of that, the reproduction has been divided into two parts. One is asexual and the second one is sexual. For this topic, we will be taking only asexual mode of reproduction, and we will be removing sexual mode of reproduction, and we will be taking that topic in our next video. So let's start the next topic, which is asexual mode of reproduction. Now, what do you mean by asexual reproduction? It means when the offspring is produced by a single parent without the involvement of gametic fusions. This kind of reproduction is called asexual reproduction. It only involves mitotic cell divisions. Offspring produced by these are exact copy, or in other term we can say them as in clone. They are just identical to their parents. Such groups of morphological and genetic similar individuals are called clones. As we can see from chart of asexual reproduction, in which it has been divided into two parts. On one side it is animals, and in second side it is in plants. In animals, it has been divided into four parts, which again subdivided into different parts. And in plants, it has been divided into vegetative propagations, and vegetative propagation has been divided into two parts, which is natural and second one is artificial. Let us start from animals. The first point comes in animals is, what do you mean by fission? In simple terms, fission is the division of parent body into two or more daughter individual identical to the parents. Fission is basically of two types. One is binary fission. Bi means two and fission means dividation. It can also be defined as the division of parent cells into two small, nearly equal sized daughter individuals, each of which rapidly grows into an adult. For example, binary fission happens in amoeba and paramecium. When we go on to the next dividation of fission, it is multiple fission. It is the division of the parent body into many small daughter individuals simultaneously. This kind of multiple fission occurs in Plasmodium and in some amoeba during unfavorable conditions. As we have completed our topic of fission, we will be moving on to our next topic, which is sporulation. Now, sporulation is just an extension of multiple fission. Sometimes the products of multiple fission become individually surrounded by resistant coat, that is cyst wall, before their release from parents. This process is called sporulation, and the cyst produced is known as spores. For example, they are mainly found in Monera, Protista and amoeba. The third topic from asexual reproduction is budding. It is a mode of asexual reproduction in which one or more unequal and small projections called buds are produced. They remain attached initially to the parent cell but eventually get separated and mature into a new offspring. It is basically of two types, external budding and internal budding. External means the bud develops as an outgrowth due to the repeated cell division on specific site on the parent. It detach themselves from the parent body and become new independent individuals, as in case of Hydra and yeast. The second point is internal budding. Internal budding is also called as gemmule formation. It is a mass of cell enclosed within a common opaque envelope rich in food, which germinates into a new plant and also called as gemmule, as you can see it from the screen. They are most common in freshwater sponges, also called as spongilla. The last topic from this mode of asexual reproduction in animals is fragmentation. It is a mode of asexual reproduction in which parent body breaks into distinct pieces, each of which regenerates into an offspring, as in case of Spirogyra and fungi. Now we are moving on to the next topic, which is asexual reproduction in plants. Asexual reproduction is commonly known as vegetative propagation in plants. These vegetative structures are also called vegetative propagules. Vegetative propagation in plants is basically of two types. One is natural vegetative propagation and the second one is artificial. Natural vegetative propagation has been divided into 6 parts and artificial has been divided into 3 parts. In natural vegetative propagation, under favorable conditions, it has roots, underground stems, creeping stems, aerial stems, leaves, bulbils, etc., in which suckers, rhizomes, bulbs, tubers, runners, offsets are some subcategories of natural vegetative propagation under favorable condition. When we are talking about artificial vegetative propagation, it has first method called as cutting. In this method, a small piece of an plant, organ, stem, root or leaf is used for propagation. Second point is layering. In this method, roots are artificially induced on branches of stem before they are detached from the plant, parent plant. Next is grafting. In this method, part of the two plants are joined in such a way that they grow as one plant. And last is known as micropropagation. This method includes propagation of plants by culturing the cells, tissues and organs in laboratory, which is called tissue culture. So micropropagation is also called tissue culture. That's all for this video. I hope you might have understood the topic discussed today. If not, you can repeat this video again for better understanding. For more topic, stay tuned to the channel. I have also attached some important list of topics to revise and learn. You can also prepare notes on the basis of these key points. See you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and do learn it.